My name is Luciana. I'm a program manager for Python in Visual Studio Code. And in this video, I'm going to be showing you three Python debugger features that will help you find and fix bugs faster in Visual Studio Code. First things first, make sure you have Visual Studio Code installed as well as the Python extension. If you don't, you can just follow the links to do so. Then you want to get started with the debugger to configure it. So once you open a Python file, it will activate the Python extension. And then you can open this debug view by clicking on this icon in VS Code, and then you can click on Create and Launch JSON file. A launch JSON file is just a configuration file to define what are the arguments for your debugger and what kind of applications it will debug. Once you click on it, you can select Python, and then you will have another list of selections you can make depending on what kind of application you're working with. If you're doing web development, with Django, Flask, FastAPI, or even Pyramid, you can select these options. But if you're only looking to debug a simple script, you can select the first option that is just a Python file. There are also other configurations for remote attach, as well as attaching to processes running on a machine, as well as Python modules. So you really just want to select the option that applies to your project that you're working on. The first feature I'm going to be covering is the Debug Console. I'm going to open Visual Studio Code here. I have an error that I have a path defined that my code is not finding it. So I'm going to show you how you can use the Debug Console to figure out how to fix this problem. So I'm going to get this line here, mask path parent, because that's what I'm trying to see to find the file at. And I can see that it's giving me a file which is basically non-existing. And if I scroll down to where this call started, I can see that it was here. And I can try to test fix for it in the Debug Console. So for example, if I call this line to get the parent of the file that I'm in, the folder parent, it will tell me that it's PVSC logo. So that is basically the workspace root. And I'm seeing that I'm trying to access images, but images is not under that. So I can see if such a fix would work would be to add logo app static to my path. And once I do so, I can see that this is a path that is actually existent in my application, all thanks to the Debug Console. So great, I can go ahead and copy this value and fix it in my code. And if you're interested in seeing if your fix has actually worked, you can come ahead and select a piece of code here. We will redefine what mask path is by right-clicking and selecting Evaluating the Debug Console, and this will simply copy and paste the code to the Debug Console. And if I do mask path, I can see that it actually defined this new value. And if I scroll up again, I'm able to do the same thing, select the code, right click, and then run Evaluating the Debug Console as well to verify my fix. The next debugger feature I'll be covering are conditional breakpoints. If you ever wanted to understand the behavior of a code only when certain condition is met, this is the feature for you. Sometimes, yeah, you can just add ifs and elves in your code and print statements, but it's much easier when you don't need to edit your code to understand what's going on. So I'm going to show how you can do that in VS Code. I'm opening VS Code again, and here I can see that I have a path and everything like we were doing, but I would like to understand the behavior of this code once this image that I'm trying to generate already exists. And I can keep deleting or not deleting my code and all of that, but I could just right click on this breakpoint and click on edit breakpoint, and then I can insert a condition that is met. So if you're working with variables, you could do if I equals 5 or if anything. In my case here, I want to make sure this will stop only when this condition is met. And if the condition is never met, it will simply skip that breakpoint and the execution will continue ignoring that. But if the condition is met, like in this case, the execution will stop at that point, as we can see here. The third feature I'll be covering today is jump to cursor. This is my favorite debugger feature of all times. It can save a lot of time for me. I'm going to open VS Code and show you how it works. So in here, I have my execution. And as I'm trying to execute this line 16 here, you're going to see that it's going to take a while because I'm trying to generate a word cloud based on a few words in the documentation. And then I'm going to generate an image, and that will not take as long.
But the thing is, sometimes I will want to re-execute previous lines of code that my debugger has already executed to understand the behavior of my code before I reach that point. Typically, what one would do is to restart the debugger so that the code could be executed again. The problem is that you saw how long it took to generate my word cloud. I don't want to keep waiting for that every time I want to evaluate pieces of code that the debugger has already passed by just because I forgot to set a breakpoint earlier on. The good news is that you don't have to.
If you right-click on the line that you want to execute next, you can go to jump to cursor, and that will define what is the next line you want to execute. And I could go as far back as the first line of my block, and then I can execute that one. And if I want to ignore the regeneration of my word cloud, I can jump to the other line and then click on jump to cursor. This really defines what is going to be the next line your debugger is going to execute, and you have this fine control of what's going to be executed next, which can save a lot of time and be super, super useful. So these were the three features I wanted to show you today. The Python debugger is very powerful. There's so much more you can do, and I'm certain you'll find even more features you'll fall in love with. So make sure you try it out. Let us know what you think. You can follow us on Twitter. You can also connect with us in our Python Discord server through the following links. Thank you so much.